also talking about how new wine can only be poured into new wineskins. As this new wine ferments and the process progresses, the new wine, because of its flexibility, would allow this process to continue to fulfillment. So we will not serve the purpose. And it's a bad idea to put new wine in old wineskins. So basically what Jesus was saying is that his teaching is the new wine. Now people of his times already had the Judaic law. And what Jesus is saying is that in contrast to the rigid Judaic laws, his teaching is the new wine that is being poured out in those times. Jesus, in those times, right, he taught differently from the other teachers. While others were teaching about law and about ritualism, here's Jesus talking about a personal relationship with God. Here's Jesus talking about an authentic spiritual life and authentic encounters that we can have with the God of the universe. Our God does new things. When we become children of God, when we accept Jesus and what he has done on the cross of Calvary, the Bible says he makes us a new creation. Have you ever thought about that? You know, God does not choose to just remodel, rebuild, recycle us, but God makes us a brand new creation. Now, we are people who prefer to camp in a comfortable zone, and that's part of our nature. But we've got to embrace the change. We've got to receive the new work of God that he is releasing into our hearts. God wants to do much more. He wants to release much more into our lives, and he's calling us forward. While we reminisce God's awesomeness, yes, in our yesterdays, no, let us also be excited about what God is going to do tomorrow. God is indeed releasing new things into our being, new things, new purposes into our lives, that he may be glorified. He's a God who renews us. He wants to renew us, and he wants to keep leading us forward. While God wants to release the new, the new word, the new revelation, the new work, new purpose, a new anointing on our lives, we are the ones who have to present ourselves as a ready vessel for what the Lord is pouring out. So the new wine requires new wineskin. And this morning, this is what I wanted to share with us, that we as God's people in every season of our lives need to come before him and ask him, Father, prepare me to be that new wineskin, because I want to receive what you are pouring out into my life. The first and foremost thing for us to prepare ourselves as the new wineskin is to offer ourselves completely to the Lord and be intimate with the Lord. We may have a hesitation and say, okay, I don't think I can move with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. But as the Lord is releasing these things upon us, we've got to yield to him and say, yes, Lord, I know you are doing this. So God, I want more of what you're doing in my life. I receive it. Trust God. As the Lord releases that new anointing, you would find that God also gives that boldness which is required. He empowers us to do what he calls us to do. Accommodate the positive change that God is bringing. And so we accommodate what the Lord is doing. By faith, we take those steps forward and say, God, I'm doing it. I know you will come through. We've got to be a people who say, God, yes, I will accommodate it in my plan, into my schedule. And whenever God does a new thing, it also stretches us.